Now, the head of the Coptic Church in Egypt has called on his followers to end their protests. Earlier on Sunday, a mob had attacked demonstrators, leaving at least 78 people injured. Christians have been protesting in Cairo for almost a week, demanding more rights. Rawia Raghi reports from Cairo.
No, no, we're not afraid of dying. That was the response Sunday morning to yet another attack on the Christian community here. Protesters who've been camped outside the state TV building for a week chanting, "Whose turn is it next?" The sit-in followed the May 7 clashes in a Cairo slum that left a church burned and 15 people dead, both Christian and Muslim. Cops coming out in force, old and young. But overnight, their gathering came under attack. Gunmen fired at the protesters and lobbed rocks and firebombs. Witnesses say the attack was coordinated and from multiple directions.
Out of nowhere, a group of men emerged from this side and started shooting at us. Later, they came from that side too. Then they started setting cars on fire and our children were injured. It's just unfair what's happening to us.
There's a lot of anger here. How is it that Christians who've been gathered to protest the very issue of lack of protection of the Coptic community have themselves come under attack? People here say they had prior warning that violence was imminent and that they warned authorities, but police failed to respond.
We are demanding that the Minister of Interior quits. I would like to say to him, for our sake, to stop it and resign, because the police were watching what happened and they took no action to protect us.
Protesters have called for a million-man march from congregations around the country. But Coptic Pope Shenouda had urged them to end their sit-in, saying the situation has become unacceptable.
The Pope means a lot to us spiritually. He's a holy man and we appreciate what he says. But we beg his pardon. We'll continue to demand our rights. We're being persecuted.
A growing confrontation that shows no signs of fading away, with the anger of this community overpowering any words of advice, even from their most revered clergymen. Al Jazeera, Cairo.